Friends, so far we have studied the analysis of the continuous beams by using the flexibility method. Now we will study how to analyze the portal frames by using the flexibility method. Here there is a problem A to B. At A, this one is on hinge. B to C, 4 meter with moment of inertia I, the C is the end support which is fixed. And A to B, the length is 12 meter with moment of inertia 4i and is subjected to a point load of 270 kN at a distance of 8 meter from A and 4 meter from B. In addition to that, it is subjected to a UDL of 40 kN per running meter over the entire length from A to B. Now, first we have to analyze, first we have to find the degree of redundancy. That is the first step. Here, the number of unknowns, you know that at hinged support, there are two reaction components as shown in figure. Similarly, at fixed end, there are three reaction components. One is H, one is V, one is M as shown in figure. Here, the total number of unknowns at the end supports, here this is one end support, this is one end support, here the total number of reactions are, unknown reactions are HA, VA, MC, VC and SC, the total number of unknowns are 5. Then the number of equilibrium equations available are 3, since the forces form a system of coplanar non-concurrent forces in equilibrium, hence the equations of equilibrium are summation of E equals 0, summation of H equals 0, summation of M equals 0. Therefore, the degree of redundancy is given by number of unknowns minus number of equations of equilibrium, that is 5 minus 3, that equals 2. Here, we have to select any two unknowns as the redundant. Here, we can consider MB as one of the redundant, here MB as one of the redundant and MC as the redundant. Here there is a moment at this joint, here you may consider that also. Here now, here in this problem we will consider HA and VA as the redundant. HA, horizontal reaction component at hinge A. Similarly, VA, vertical reaction component at hinge A as the redundant. Hence, the redundant matrix is given by R equals HA and VA of order 2 into 2 by 1. Then, first we have to remove the redundance, draw the basic diagram subjected to applied loads, and then find the displacement due to the applied loads. Here, by removing the redundance at A, here in the direction of the redundance, write down the coordinate numbers. Here HA is the first redundant, we have written coordinate 1. VA is the second redundant, in place of VA we have written the coordinate 2. Then we have shown the forces acting on this. Here this is UDL of 40 kN per running meter. This is 270 kN at a distance of 4 meter from B and 8 meter from A. And in between B and C, there are no loads. Here, to find the displacement due to the applied loads in the coordinate directions 1 and 2, we have to make use of the unit load method. Here, in place of HA, apply, in place of redundant HA, apply a unit load of 1 kN as shown in figure 2. Here, this one is in place of HA or in the coordinate direction. Here, this is the assumed direction. This is not the exact direction. Apply a unit load in horizontal direction at A. Then, similarly, to get the displacement at due to the vertical redundant VA, here we can apply the unit load in the assumed direction of the redundant VA. Now we can get the displacement due to the loads. Here, by using the unit load method, here first we have to calculate the displacement due to the loads, and then by using these three diagrams we can find the displacement due to the applied loads and then the displacement due to the unit loads in the direction of the redundance. Here this one is F11 of the flexibility matrix elements you can get by using these two diagrams. Here the displacement due to the applied load that you can get by using these three diagrams. Here the portion is A to D. Here we can consider A as the origin. We have to select a section at a distance of x from A. The limits of x varies from 0 to 8. In between A to D, the limits are 0 to 8. Then here in this portion in between A and D, there is only one UDL in this diagram. First diagram, there is only one load, that is UDL. The moment due to this UDL about section XX, that is 40 into X into X by 2, that is hogging, hence that is negative, that is minus 40 X square by 2, that equals minus 20 X square. Similarly, in the second diagram, due to the unit load applied in the direction of coordinate 1, here the perpendicular distance is 0. Here the distance is x, the perpendicular distance is 0. Therefore, M1 equals, that is the moment due to the unit load applied in the coordinate direction 1, that is 0. Then, in the third diagram, the moment due to the unit load applied in the direction of coordinate 2, that is 1 kilonewton, we have assumed in upward direction, 1 into x, that is x. Here, in this portion, the moment of inertia is 4i, hence, the flexural rigidity is 4 times i. Similarly, from D to B, here, we can consider D as the origin, the limits of x varies from 0 to 4 meter. X varies from 0 D to B, that means the limits are 0 to 4. Then here we can consider a section at a distance of X from D. Then the moment to this UDL, that is given by here, the total distance becomes from A to this section, that is 8 plus X. The moment is hogging, the total distance is 8 plus X. Then 40 into 8 plus x into half of 8 plus x, that is hogging, minus 40 into 8 plus x whole square divided by 2 due to this UDL. Then due to this point load is acting at a distance of x from the section. Then 270 into x, that is also hogging. And then due to this unit load in the figure 2, the unit load acting in the direction of the redundant 1, that is 1 into perpendicular distance is 0. Then due to the unit load applied in the coordinate direction 2, here the distance is 8 plus x. Here we have considered the section in between D and C. Then 1 into 8 plus x. Then the moment of inertia is 4i in between A and B, hence the flexural rigidity is 4 times EI. Then in portion B to C, that is for vertical column, in portion B to C, B as the origin, here we can consider a section at a distance of x from B. Here the B is the origin, the limits are x varies from 0 to 0 at B and 4 meter at C. Then the bending moment in this portion, that is 40, that is hogging, 40 into 12 into half of 12, that is hogging, hence that is minus 40 into 12 square by 2 due to this point load, that is 270 into 4. Here the bending moment remains constant from B to C due to this UDL and point load, that is given by minus 40 into 12 square by 2 minus 270 into 4 due to the applied load. And due to the unit load in the direction of coordinate 1, that is 1 into x, the perpendicular distance is x, and the bending moment is sagging in nature, hence we have put the positive sign. Due to the redundant in the direction of coordinate 2, that is 1 into 12, it remains constant from B to C, that is also sagging, hence that is positive. The flexural rigidity is EI, here the moment of inertia is 1I. Now, by using these details, we can calculate the displacement due to the loads in the coordinates direction 1 and 2, that is delta L1. Delta L1 is given by, we know that by the unit load method, the deflection at any point, deflection in the direction of the coordinate 1 is given by M into M1 into dx, where M is the bending moment due to the applied loads, M1 is the bending moment due to unit load in the direction of the redundant, that is M into M1 dx divided by EI with it integration within the reverse 0 to L. Here, by observing this, in portion AD and DB, M1 is 0, hence the both the terms are becomes M into M1 is 0, M into M1 is 0 in both these portions. In portion BC, that is here, after simplification of this M, that is minus 40 into 12 square by 2, minus 270 into 4, that becomes minus 3960, that is 3960, into this M1, that is X, that is minus 3960 X divided by EI into DX. After integration and substituting the limits, here the integration of X DX is X square by 2, and 3960 becomes constant. Then, that is, after substituting the limits and after integration, and you will get the delta L1, that is displacement due to the load in the direction of coordinate 1, that one is minus 31680 by EI. Then similarly, delta L2 in the direction of the displacement in the direction of coordinate 2 due to the applied load, that one is here, to get the displacement in the direction of the coordinate 2 due to the applied load, we have applied the unit load at coordinate 2, that is M into M2, where M is the bending moment due to the loads, M2 is the bending moment due to the unit load in the direction of the coordinate 2. Then here the limits of integration are 0 to L, M into M2 dx divided by EI. Here start from the section portion AB, here that is minus 20x square into M2 is x, that is minus 20x square into x dx divided by the flexural rigidity is 4 times EI. Then 0 to 8, the limits are 0 to 8. For the second portion, that is D to B, that is here we have calculated the bending moment, that is minus 40 by 2, that is minus 20 into 8 plus x whole square, minus 270x, minus 270x, minus 270x inside the bracket into x plus 8 dx divided by the flexural rigidity is 4 times EI. Then here next portion, that is in portion B to C, here after the calculation of this, that is by simplification, here you will get minus 40 by 2, that is 20 into 12 square minus 270 into 4, you will get minus 3960 into M2 is 12 dx divided by EI. Now we can get delta L2 equals, here after simplification, here integration of this one is 0 to 8, the limits are 0 to 8, minus 20x cube divided by 4 EI dx, here as expand this term, that is minus 20 into x square, x plus 8 whole square, you can expand, and then you will get x square plus 16x plus 64 minus 270x into, in the bracket, x plus 8 dx divided by 4a, the last term in portion c to d, that is b to c, that is the limits are 0 to 4, minus 47520 by a into dx. Then after simplification, after integration, and by substituting the limits, this one is minus 20x to the power of 4 divided by 4 times 4a. Since the integration of x cube is x to the power of 4 by 4, then the within the limits 0 to 8. Here, after simplification, here we have to expand this term again. Then here, that is minus 20x square minus 320x minus 1280 minus 270x into x plus 8 divided by 4a. Then here this term becomes integration of 47520 dx, that becomes 47520x divided by a within the limits 0 to 4. By substituting the limits, upper limits, that is 8, that is minus 20 into 8 to the power of 4 divided by 16 a, here you will get, that is minus 5120 by a. Similarly, the second term, if we integrate this and simplify this, if you expand this, here you will get minus 20x cube minus 320x square minus 1280x minus 270x square minus 160x square minus 2560x minus 10240 minus 2160x dx. After simplification only, you can integrate that term. Then here you will get, after simplification, here the first term is, after simplification you will get minus 5120 by EI. The last term, that is minus 1900080, that is 190,080 divided by EI. The second term, that is integration of that one, is minus 20x to the power of 4 by 4 minus 750x cube by 3 minus 6000x square by 2 minus 10240x. Then within the limits 0 to a 4 divided by 4ei. Then after simplification, that is minus 5120 minus 190080 minus 26560 by ei. Here you will get a value of 221,760 by ei. Now you have got the displacement due to the loads. Now to get the flexibility coefficients, here we have already applied the unit load in place of the redundance in direction coordinate 1. Along the coordinate 1 we have applied the unit load. Similarly, along the coordinate 2 we have applied the unit load. Then F11, that is the flexibility element 11, is given by M1 into M1 dx divided by EI, where M1 is the bending moment due to the unit load applied in the direction of the coordinate 1. For portions AB, for A to C, here in this diagram, in this second diagram, here this is A to C, A to D to B, the bending moment is 0 only in the portion BC, that is X. Hence the displacement or flexibility matrix due to the unit load in the direction of the coordinate 1, that one is M1 square dx divided by EI, M1 square into dx divided by EI, that is x into x square divided by EI into dx, 0 to 4 is the limits. Then integration of x square is x cube by 3EI, that is 0 to 4 are the limits. Then by substituting the limits, that is 64 by EI. Then F12 and F21, M1 into M2 dx divided by EI. Here in the first two portions, that is M1 is 0, only the last term, that is in portion BC, M1 x and M2 is 12. Hence the displacement or the flexibility coefficient F12, that one is M1 into M2 dx divided by EI, that is the only in the last term B to C, that is 12 into x, m1 is x and m2 is 12, then m1 m2 is 12x dx divided by EI. After integration, that is 12x square by 2 EI, the limits are 0 to 4, that is 96 by EI. Then F22, that is F22, that is the flexibility element, that is the displacement at 2 due to the load, unit load applied in the direction of the coordinate 2, that one is m2 square dx divided by EI. Here the in portion, first portion x, that is m2 is x, in second portion x plus 8, in the third portion, that is 12, the flexural rigidity 4 EI for A to D and D to B. Now we can make use of that one. Here F22, that is the flexibility element or the displacement due to the unit load in the direction of the coordinate 2 and the load applied at 2, that one is here m2 square dx divided by EI within the limits 0 to L. Here if we integrate that, then in the first portion x is the moment to 2, the unit load applied in the direction of the coordinate, that is x into x, x square dx, the limits are 0 to 8, the flexural rigidity is EI. Similarly, in the second portion, that is D to B, the limits are 0 to 4 and the moment is x plus 8, m2 is x plus 8, m2 into m2, that is x plus 8 whole square divided by 4 EI dx, the flexural rigidity is 4 times EI. In the third portion, the bending moment due to the unit load applied in the direction of the coordinate 2, that is 12, 12 into 12, that is m2 square divided by flexural rigidity is EI, the limits are 0 to 4. Then after integrating m2, that is x square, that is x cube by 3 into 4, that is x cube by 12, that is 8 to the power of 3 divided by 12 EI, then by expanding this term and then integrate, that is x square plus 16x plus 64 dx divided by 4 EI, that is the last term is 12 square, that is 144 into x divided by EI. By substituting the limits, that is 144 into 4 by EI. Then after simplification, that is 8 to the power of 3 divided by 3 into 4, that is 8 to the power of 3 divided by 12 EI, here you will get 42.67 by EI. Similarly, the second term, if we integrate this, that is 1 divided by 4 EI, that is x square, integration of x square is x cube by 3, by substituting the limits, that is 64 by 3. Then after integration of the second term, that is 16x, integration of 16x is 16x square by 2, by substituting the limits 16 by 2 into 4 square, that is 16. And then the integration of the last term, that is 64, that is 6, that becomes 64x, by substituting the limits 64 into 4 plus the last term, that is 144 into 4, that is 576 by EI. After simplification, here you will get 720 by EI. Now we will get, we can easily write the flexibility matrix, that is F11, F12, F21, F22 are the elements of the flexibility matrix of order 2 by 2. Then 1 over EI is common, F11 is 64 by 3, F12, that is 96, F21, that is also 96, and F22, that is 720. Here to get the final values of the redundant, we know that by the equation R equals redundant matrix is given by inverse of the flexibility matrix into the displacement vector due to sinking and settlement of the support minus the settlement due to the displacement due to the load supplied. Here we have considered HEI and VA as the redundant. Here EI is 1 over EI, that is inverse of 1 over EI is EI, inverse of the flexibility matrix, that is 64 by 3, 96, 96 and 720. Here you can calculate the inverse of this matrix into the displacement due to settlement or sinking of the supports is 0, 0 minus the values are like this, then 31,680 by EI. This one is 221,760 by EI. then HA and VA by using the inverse of flexibility matrix, HA and VA, HA equals to
the values of HA equals to 47.5, VA equals to 75 kilonewton. They are the redundants. Now we can find the other forces. Here HA equals to 47.5 kilonewton, VA equals 275 kilonewton. By drawing the free body diagram of AB, here HA is 247.5, just now we have calculated. VA equals 275 kilonewton. VB is the reaction at vertical reaction at B. HB is the horizontal reaction at B. MB is the moment for span. AB summation of H equals 0, therefore HB equals 247.5 kilonewton, which is acting towards left side as shown in figure. Similarly, summation of phi equals 0, that is Vb equals, that is 400 into total span is 12 plus 270 minus Va, that is 275, that equals Vb equals 475 kilonewton upward. Then summation of Ma equals 0. By taking sum of the moments of all the forces about A equals 0, we will get 270 into 8, this one moment to 2 point load, 400 into 12 into 6, that is due to UDL, plus MB. Here all these moments are clockwise. Then minus 475 into 12 due to VB, that is anticlockwise, therefore MB equals, that is 660 kilonewton meter as shown in figure. This is the clockwise moment. Similarly, for span BC, for vertical member BC, if you draw the free body diagram of that one, here in this HB is acting towards left side, here HB is acting towards right side, both are equal and opposite, and VB, here VB is upward for span BA, VB is downward for span BC. Then here MB is clockwise for AB, MB is anticlockwise for vertical member BC. Then by applying the equilibrium equation for span BC, HB equals 247.5 kilonewton towards right side, VB equals VC, then that is 475 kilonewton. By applying the equilibrium equation, VC is upward. Then SC equals, that is by applying another equilibrium equation, that is 247.5 kilonewton, that is towards left side. Then summation of MB equals 0, that is HB into 4 plus MC, that is clockwise, minus MB, that is anticlockwise, that equals 0. Then 247.5 into 4, that is 247.5 into 4, that is clockwise, plus MC, that is clockwise, minus MB, that is 660 kilonewton meter anticlockwise, therefore MC equals minus 330 kilonewton meter. Our assumption is wrong, hence MC is in anticlockwise direction, that is 330 kilonewton meter as shown in the, as shown by the value shown in figure. After getting the values of the support reactions and the bending moments, now we can easily draw the bending moment diagram. Here due to the UDL, this portion is curved for the bending moment diagram. Here the support moment is 660 kilonewton meter, that is hugging moment. Hence at support, due to UDL and point load, that is the maximum bending moment occurs below the point load, that is 920 kilonewton meter. And here this one is hugging, this one is sagging. This is the bending moment for the above problem. And then here the support reaction is 275. Here the shear force variation is like this, 270 minus 40 into 8, that is minus 45 kilonewton because of this point load, that is minus 45 minus 270, that is 315 kilonewton. Again due to UDL, that is minus 40 into 4, that one is 475. Due to the support reaction at B, that is 475, here the shear force is 0. Here for the vertical member, left upward is positive, that is 247.5. This one is also 247.5, it remains constant. This is the shear force and bending moment diagram for the given